Hi guys and girls, and welcome to another episode of Money Minutes, this time in the pouring rain, difficult circumstances. Anyway, we're going to talk about knowledge sharing today, and also about the cake principle and why it is important to share your knowledge. So sit back, relax, and learn something, why knowledge sharing is crucial in the workplace. I also discovered one or two very new interesting things. I'll let you know. These were very cool. Oh, and by the way, thank you for more than 5,000 clicks. You've been really, really kind. So knowledge sharing is an activity through which information, skills and expertise is exchanged between people, friends and within an organization. So what's the alternative? Knowledge hoarding. It doesn't sound very nice, right? It reminds me of school and this overachiever who wouldn't let me copy his answers in tests. Back when nerds weren't cool at all, you know. I'm sure you know these frustrating people. You even work with them. The fear to share the knowledge seems almost a bit backwards. We talk about this later. Let's talk about the cake concept developed by Gurman. To make knowledge productive, you need information. So you know how to make a cake. This is the know-how. But this is not sufficient. You also need a list of ingredients and to decide what cake to make. So you need information. Now why is also important. Knowing what ingredient is missing and what's the purpose of this missing ingredient allows the cook to improvise. Now why is more important than know-how. Because now why allows you to be creative to reinvent the know-how. Do not believe in the fallacy that sharing makes you lose an advantage. Do not fear. Make it a habit to share knowledge. And here's why. Number one, fast solutions, improved response time. You are in a team trying to solve a problem, then someone who shares how he or she solved the problem before can lead to faster solutions and also an improved response time now and in the future if it is shared and also refined in new teams. Number two, it increases coordination. Sharing with others makes you comfortable and it's easier to coordinate with others and be more efficient and at home in your organization where you work. Three, accepting new ideas. You like being outdated? I don't think so. You want to be a part of a team and valued. Sharing helps you a lot. Be more open at work and in your relationships with other people. This can make you feel more needed at work and open you up to new ideas. Yeah, this all sounds good, but why should I do it? Because knowledge is short-lived. If you do not make use of your knowledge, it loses its value. If you do not share your knowledge, then someone else with that knowledge will. So why not be the first? By sharing your knowledge, you gain more than you lose. If I talk to another person, then I benefit from their knowledge and from their unique insights. For most people, sharing is just not about giving. It's about four things: feedback and advice, asking questions and asking for help, even when it comes to small things, asking someone to work with you in some way, however small, and next thing is telling people what you're doing and more importantly, why you're doing it. And by the way, here are my top five, my personal favorites. You can limit the skill gap. Teams are only as strong as their weakest member. By sharing knowledge, you create a new, cool work environment where people feel at home. They are encouraged to ask questions. The result is you make people feel more at home at your workplace. Number two, team cementing. A better and more efficient team can reach a higher level of energy when trying to reach one goal together as a group. So knowledge sharing is good in achieving this. Number three, it helps you grow and stay motivated. It's not all about skills, it is about the will to learn new ones. Growth means continuous development, and continuous growth means continuous development. Number four, increase innovation. Gertian's know why principle, the more knowledge people have, the more you can innovate. Number five, sense of purpose. You're not just doing stuff anymore. In this environment, you have a purpose. Work with no purpose is frustrating. Now you're thinking, great, I want to do it, but how? Overcome your objections and fears. I talked about that fallacy before, but also sharing is a mindset, so everyone can do it. Knowledge sharing isn't about blindly sharing everything. You need some judgment. If you have a great idea, don't share it with a competitor, but also find a new way to make more of it by choosing to work with other people. And last but not least, knowledge sharing is about improving by sharing little things. Share them with others. and maybe they will share relevant knowledge with you. For example, sometimes people ask me questions about film and then I realize that I never thought of this before and start investigating. This enriches my life and by knowing more about my own process. Plus, I helped at least one person. And by putting it out there, I make it available to 100 more people for years. Next episode's question, how do I make people turn a script into a movie? So that's been it. Thank you very much for watching me talking about sharing knowledge in the rain. And so stay curious and keep on learning. And happy sharing. Bye.